Hello, this is Mark Wildman of Wildman Athletica, and today we are going to talk about our outside transition continuous four time with a club. We have both an inside transition and we have an outside transition, and they are slightly different rotations. So we have our four major rotations that we're always trying to work on: right hand inside, right hand outside, left hand inside, left hand outside. People tend to be better at the inside rotation because that's how most sports are done, with an inside rotation. But if you do martial arts or anything like that, then there are also lots of outside transitions, which you will see all the time. So we want to learn to rotate, sit into our back hip, keep our ankle and our knee strong, and that's what this exercise is for. Let's demonstrate. With this exercise, we want to point our feet generally straight ahead. Even a little bit of turnout as we're doing this will cause some weird things to happen back and forth with our knees. So in the interest of keeping our knees healthy until we're 95, we are going to point our feet straight ahead. If you find your feet, your heels lifting up as you go, overturn your feet in just 5 degrees to force you further into your heels. We're gonna set our feet up straight ahead. For demonstration purposes, we're gonna do 3 outside circles, a transition, 3 outside circles, and then a transition, and then we are going to transition back and forth from side to side 4 time. This exercise is normally done 4 time. Outside circles, 1, 2, 3, transition, 1, 2, 3, and now we're gonna transition continuously. Transition, 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 transition. So what you're gonna notice is the heavier this weight gets, the more you're going to sit back into your rear hip. So we're always working on this rear hip position. You will think of this as a side hip snap. Instead of just a front hip snap, deadlift, snatch, swing, snapping just front, here we are snapping from side to side, side to side. And if you're very athletic and you do a lot of sports, you will recognize these positions happen a lot when you change directions rapidly. Most people have had ankle or knee injuries at some point in their past, so we like to do this in the beginning with no foot movement. There are versions of this later, which are continuous and walking drills that have foot movement in them, but it always starts with the stable platform first. Build yourself up in weight. The heavier the weight gets, the more you're gonna figure out how to do these hip movements back and forth from side to side. And if you're like me and you have bad knees, we have to find ways to train our rotation that aren't gonna have impact, repeated stress on our joints, because we wanna live a long time and we wanna continue to do sports. This has been Mark Wildman of Wildman Athletica.